back here live in Los Angeles. Jumpman, beautiful afternoon. And big weekend for the Jumpman.
I'll be damned if I wear any of the shoes for Michael Jordan making.
Going to be adorning the All-Star jerseys for the first time. The logo of Jordan Brand.
That's sweet right there.
And one of the All-Stars you'll see on Sunday, playing on Team LeBron.
Got that fresh cut, too. Look at him, Kenny.
That's a Charlotte cut on. That's a New York City cut.
New York.
Yeah, he went back home.
For the Bronx, man.
He went back and got that.
By the way, Kemba Walker joining us now. Second straight All-Star appearance. It's always interesting, I think, to see how players approach this as being an honor to be there or as a learning experience, that kind of thing. What do you take away from being an All-Star weekend, Kemba?
I think for me, it's a camaraderie. You know, being around the guys that you compete with on a daily basis. You know, we don't get a chance to really communicate, you know, as much as we would like to because
some of those
you know,
dudes,
we're playing.
I see them on vacations together. Some of the guys.
Kemba,
really.
you're very close guard. You're not really talked about a lot. So is this your moment? Like when you get in the game, do you say to yourself, you know what? I'm gonna make sure people know the name Kemba Walker Day. Are you gonna go for the MVP or are you just gonna go catch a sweat and then, you know, just chill out? Or are you gonna go for it?
You know what? I think the star to set the tone, you know? But when I get in there, I try to have fun, you know, do what I can do. I definitely want to score. I mean, can't go in the game and not score. My friend's gonna kill me for that. But I try to enjoy myself.
You know, if you look at what you've done and what you accomplished and where Charlotte is now, what makes you guys take that next step and be playoff bound, keeping the atmosphere in Charlotte and that type of excitement?
We got to get more consistent. I mean, that's the biggest key. You know, consistency is really important. That's where we struggle, right, at this moment. So, you know, as long as we get more consistent,
try to win
some more games, we'll be fine.
Well, let me ask you this question. You played well this year. The Whites played well this year. What's the deal with Nicholas Batum?
You know what? I think his injury early on, you know, messed him up a little bit with his rhythm. And, you know, he's still trying to find that balance, you know, still trying to find his rhythm. So, you know, it takes time. And I know the season is winding down, but, you know, I think this break will help all of us, definitely him. And, you know, we're going to, you know, try and kick things up a little bit.
Let me ask you about what the last couple of weeks have been like for you. All seven seasons of your career have been in Charlotte. I was reading Rick Bunnell's profile of you in the Charlotte Observer, and he talked about the fact that you're building a new house there. This is where you live, but your name was out there as, you know, at the trade deadline. Real talk about what it's like to be a professional and be looking at, boy, are we going to have to pick up and go? What is that like for you? What's it like for your family?
You know, it was the first time, you know, that my name has, you know, been on the trading block, so. You know, it was a little bit disturbing, of course, but, you know, it's a part of the business. You know, obviously, you know, Charlotte's where I want to be. I mean, I've been there for the, you know, last 7 years, and it was the place where I got my opportunity, the place where I got my start. And, you know, I've grown to love the city. The city has grown to love me. So, you know, it was kind of frustrating to hear those rumors, but
Did Michael talk to you about that?
He did. And he kept it real with me. I mean, he's a really honest guy, and he called me, and, you know, he let me know what it was. You know, he told me, you know, teams were calling, and they had to listen.
So let me ask you a question. When Michael calls you, what is he, does he say, it's Michael?
And you,
I know who it is.
That number
caller ID.
Yeah, it shows up.
I got his number in my phone.
But I'm just saying, though, I'm just asking you, though, when he called, does he just say, it's Michael or the boss or what?
He just say, what's up, dude?
Okay.
I already know who it is.
Okay.
You know, something else that...
When Michael used to call you, he don't call you no more.
Before you upset him.
Yeah.
Before you upset him.
What he used to say when he used to call you?
Yo, fat boy. That's exactly what he said every single time. Yo, fat boy.
Let's talk about something else that I was reading this... sure you're 6'1", 170. All right, not the biggest guy, not the biggest guy out there.
Kemba, he's not 6'1", man.
But you say sometimes I feel like a giant. Okay, so number one, how tall are you?
I'm 6 feet.
Yeah, thank you.
6 feet. Okay. Yeah, sometimes you feel like a giant. They said, and Alvin Gentry said that he can't think of a more competitive player he's ever met. He said you're right there with Kobe on the competitive scale.
Those are great words. I mean,
but is that something that you have intentionally been? Look, you're not going to outwork me. You're not going to outcompete me.
Oh, no question.
Goodness. I mean, since
I'm
when?
A small guy.
Yeah. I mean, since
my whole
since
basketball
growing
career.
Up.
Yeah. I mean, I've always been small. Can't change that. So, you know, something, you know, that gets me over the top is my competitive nature, and you know, I bring that with me every single day, you know, on the basketball court.
You did All-Star Weekend. What's the goals for the Charlotte Hornets after All-Star Weekend?
I mean, we got to pick it up.
Goals set for the team.
We got to win. That's it. I mean, it's no other way to put it. We got to, you know, take it day by day, game by game, and we got to rack these wins up if we really want to make a push.
All right, we say Charlotte got to play better. Kemba Walker has to do. What do you have to improve in the second? These last 25 games to make that happen individually. Forget about the team. Mm-hmm. What you do will make the team go, because between yourself and now Dwight at times, but you're going to make it go. So what do you have to do differently?
My leadership.
Okay.
You know, it has to be top notch. And, you know, I'm going to score, you know, I'm going to, you know, play well on the court. And, you know, but for the most part, I got to bring people along with me. And that's my goal for the second half of the season.
Last question. How much that bracelet cost?
Oh, man. Oh, mine?
No. I didn't say it's a $12
bracelet. I got this
bracelet. Oh, we need to see that, Kemba.
No, it is good, man.
It was a gift, man. It was a gift.
Well, you come on.
This is the NBA. Never ask how much a gift costs.
This is the NBA, man. Yeah, the guys have money,
listen,
Chuck.
I got one of those in the steam room. Ain't no big deal. Yeah.
Yours was rubber.
The number 9 pick of the 2011 draft, and now is second time as an NBA All-Star, Kemba Walker. Have a great time.